Forces the Rangers to regroup. Zibanejad, who had two goals Tuesday night, feeds it back to the line. And now Panarin with it. Panarin goes cross ice. Zibanejad to Kreider, who finishes a power play goal for Kreider, who led the NHL last year with 26 goals on the man advantage, has a power play tally here, and the Rangers have an early 1-0 lead. Across to Miller. Miller tried to weave it past Brodin, but Brodin had none of that, got a stick on it. Panarin recovers in the corner. Sets up behind the Minnesota goal. Long shift for Kaprizov. Lafreniere centers, they score. Fox sneaking in from the point. Beats Fleury, and the Rangers have extended the lead to 2-0. In which the Wild nab Marco Rossi with pick number 9. Miller laid it across. Trocheck sends it in. Lafreniere in the corner, tried to center. Panarin's there, and he scores! Second assist of the period for Lafreniere. And Panarin with the goal. The Rangers have jumped out to a 3-0 lead.
Well, you talked about the Rangers finding some life seconds left. It's the depth here. You know, the 1-2 punch, Panarin, then you've got the Zibanejad line. The Wild have spent altogether too much time defending, too much room through the middle of the ice, the slot. Marco Rossi kind of gets caught in the middle of no man's land. Matt Dumba cannot recover in time. Panarin with the patience. Boy, he put one on Marc-Andre Fleury there, too.
Fleury was a great player. And yet, he spent parts of two seasons in the minors.
And that's probably part of the reason why he believes so heavily on having all the prospects play there.
Lafreniere's shot was blocked. Panarin got it back, plays it cross ice, and they score. Trocheck beats Fleury on the one-timer, and the Rangers extend the lead to 5-1.
On the backhand, slick little play. Yeah, they steal the puck. Panarin steals it backhanded over there. A one-timer from Lafreniere. Panarin, I think there's no doubt about it. He's been the best player on the ice here tonight. Very noticeable.